Hey everybody. So I haven't had access to my laptop charger. I've been, if you can see, like look around. I've been traveling, right? Like, and I'm traveling right now. Like, I'm traveling at the moment, and I've been traveling, and then I'll be traveling until Tuesday, and then I left my charger in San Diego, and I won't be back in San Diego until Tuesday, and. I like my laptop. It's a very cool, expensive laptop, but like, it's like, it's like this like square type of plug that is only for the, like, it's like the, Asus Tough Gaming or whatever. And it's like only for that laptop. And like, I literally can't buy I can't go into any store anywhere near me within like hundreds of miles and buy a replacement charger for this laptop. So that's kind of been my situation for the last few days, and that's kind of like been where I've been at, right? And then so I have like this iPad that I'm shooting on right now, and that's like basically been like that, and like that's been like my computer for the last few days, and it'll be my computer through the weekend essentially. So that's kind of how I've been rolling overall. But within that, I have been still paying attention to the research papers that have come out. And unfortunately, I can't like directly, I don't have a way to direct link to the research paper that I'm going to reference within this video, but it was on Hugging Face. It was published on, so Hugging Face published it. It's an archive paper, and Hugging Face published it yesterday is when I read it overall. And then the paper is essentially describes and goes into the fact that what they found is that the probability distribution for any problem that an LLM model can solve is already in existence prior to training the LLM model, which is a big question. That's a huge research question, that like a very, very prominent research question. Like, I can tell you like with certainty that there are companies literally built on that research question, right? And this research paper just flat out proves it, like that yes, that the answer is yes, that anything that could exist within the like probability distribution of the model and asking it within that model can be discovered without and prior to like training the model. So essentially what that means, like what that breaks down to is that like training is actually like bad overall for the model, right? Which it presents an interesting and a unique dilemma and a unique situation and problem within that overall, right? To me, it's like it boils back down to, and it comes back down to this concept of what exactly is computer science, right? And that's been the question that has been discussed ever since computer science, because it's like really neither computers nor science overall as to how it works, right? And to me, like, AI kind of falls a lot into that same bucket, and I always try to me, nothing falls into that bucket overall, but to a lot of people, everything falls into those buckets, right? And to me, like, nothing does. And then so it's if something is falling into those buckets, then there's a fundamental, like, there's something that we don't understand about it overall, right? And it just needs to be like dug deeper in order to figure out like what is the missing layer, like the missing element within that overall. And then so within that and within this particular problem, like the digging deeper and the missing element within it is like exactly that, right? That the answer to that overarching question of does the training actually exists, or does the answer to a problem that you would want to ask the model that the model can answer with via training actually exist without training the model, right? And then within that, so like we know at this point that training a model and fine-tuning a model, things like that are like and can be damaging overall to the latent space. Like it's why isn't a model generalizable, and like why aren't the models generalizable? Like that's one of the problems within that, right? It's not the only problem within that, but that's one of the biggest problems within that is that so you take a model and then you train it, and then even if you train it on a data set, and we'll call that data set the internet or the entirety of human knowledge, it's still like warping and creating probability distributions within that latent space that wouldn't exist naturally overall. I think that'd be the best way to put it, right? And then so within that and from that, we know that this training element is like not good overall. There has to be a better method than this method that exists. And then so what would that better method be? The very first question that needs to be answered when you dive into that is, does the probability distribution of whatever you're trying to solve for actually exist a priori to the training, or does it get introduced via the training, right? And so I said, like, those are two different things and two different elements, right? And then it's important, and that distinction within it is very important as well, right? Because to me, like, the next step that comes from that is a very important philosophical distinction to make, and it's important to state it explicitly as it is, right? Which is that, so within that and acknowledging that framework, the next step within that is that the models do not, like, that then the next question will be like, do the models learn from the information, right? And then so very specifically, the philosophical next step answer to that question based off of all of this would be that no, the models do not learn based off of the information, based off of any current definitions of learning that we currently employ overall. That would be the best way that I could frame that overall, right? I think that's the most proper way overall to frame that, and like it would be a truthful framing within that to frame it within in that manner. Diving deeper into that, and then just like discussing that more within that, right? Essentially, what that means is that like the answer is again like existence a priori within the latent space is basically what that means, and then so the model isn't learning the answer, and then so it could, like, the what the model is doing via training then is learning better probability distributions that lead it towards that answer more of the time. but again, like, that doesn't fall under any definition of learning that anyone would typically make within that, right? And then, like, so the next argument to make within, like, the next philosophical argument that, like, I, like, to me, that naturally pops into my head within that is like, can I prove that my mechanical thought processes do not fall within that realm? And no, I can't, right? And then so to me, that's where I end the philosophical discussion, because I can't get past that point at that point, right? I can't. So I can, like, essentially we have an answer to a major question that has been thought about, and people have been discussing this question for a long time now, which is for like since the existence of these models, which is like, is that question, is the answer to that question that you're asking the model in existence a priori? And yes, it is. So then that means that the models don't learn according to any sort of definition that is standard, according to any definition that you would want to lay out within that. And that would be yes as well, right? So yes and yes to both of those questions. But then does that change anything overall philosophically in the end? No, that's up to you then within that, right? Does that change anything for you? I don't know. If it does, it does. If it does, it doesn't. Or if it doesn't, it doesn't. That's kind of what it does. But it doesn't inherently change anything within that overall, because then the next question within that becomes like, is my learning process within that the same as that? And I can't prove or disprove that overall. So then it becomes kind of a moot point past that until we get like further data overall with regards towards the overall like status of the situation, I guess would be the best way to frame that and put that overall, right? But in non-philosophical terms, like bringing this down into real world, like the actual like real world implications of this, it's we're getting to the like brass tacks of the situation now, right? Like it's bad and good overall. Like I think you're gonna see exactly what you're seeing right now in the status quo, right? Like more and more disparity in the status quo. I don't think it's going to go away on any level whatsoever. Within that, you're going to see more and more of that. And I don't know how else to frame that overall, right? Like, I'm on Prosperity Avenue right now and vacationing around there in that area. And then Prosperity Avenue is very, to me, symptomatic of exactly this, right? Like I've never seen such disparities and discrepancies on Prosperity Avenue. It's like two different worlds and like depending on which side of the avenue that you're looking at, right? And that's what I mean and I boiled these things down within that overall. And then these things have very big real world ramifications within it, right? So the biggest real world ramification within all of this and the big thing that is on people's minds is like, is AI a bubble or is it not? And then it's like, yes, the answer is yes, right? And then like, it's a bubble and it's not, I don't know, because it boils down to these elements, right? Like it's a bubble because of the fact that exactly what I've been saying from the beginning, that people have been over invested in the wrong portions of all of this. But then it's also not a bubble because it's real overall, right? And this has real ramifications and real impacts. But like so stepping away from the philosophical impact of it, the economic impact of it is, I think, like, it's a lot different than people think overall, right? Like it's hard, like it's the reverse of monetizable, and that's the problem with it. And that's like it's a big problem within our current structure overall, which is the fact that so essentially what this boils it down to is like, so any problem that exists, you can know whether or not, like upfront, like do I have enough like compute, enough power, enough resources, enough architecture to answer this question, whatever the question is, right? Like, and you can scale up the question if you have enough architectural resources in order to answer that question, and then you would know upfront before investing in those architectural resources if you can answer that question or not, and then you don't need to train. You could instantaneously, just once you have the architecture dialed in, get the answer to that question overall, which like essentially removes the barriers for these things. Like, so like I guess the best way that I could break this down. And so let's say that like tomorrow I invented an engine and this engine operates 100% off of air, right? Like it converts air into air. And 70% nitrogen, 20% oxygen, 10% phosphorus, like whatever, the literal chemical element is, it takes that in and that's the exact output, right? And so that's kind of the opposite of monetizable, right? It's infinitely scalable. Like that's the good thing about that. Like it's just taking in a the most abundant resource on earth and then outputting the same thing. So it's there's no net decrease in the expenditure there. So like a lot of people would flood into that and a lot of people would be interested in that engine, and the engine could do a lot of good overall for the world. Like, that would be like, I mean, there would be a lot of things that you could do with the air engine, right? It runs on air, but like, it would kill the economy, like the economy as we know it, would be pretty wiped out, right? Like that's, and people could acknowledge that, like, yeah, if there was an air engine like that existed tomorrow, I could like really easily conceive that the economy would be wiped. Like, here we are. Like, and so, the air engine exists. It's just that we call AI, right? And then, so, within that, like, it's going to wipe economies and, do these things and operate in these ways. and that's going to be good and bad overall, right? And there's no changing that equation overall. There's betting on the wrong parts of it, and there's like really easy to make wrong bets overall. And so I guess that's the way that I'll wrap this video. I'll try to make a few more videos if I can before Tuesday, but just letting you know overall, this is kind of my situation and my current setup overall. If you like this format, like let me know. This is a very different format than I typically do. But so, and if you like this type of content, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.